We're looking at question number 23, and it's asking us to graph f as a solid line and the inverse of f as a dashed line in the same rectangular coordinate system, and to use integral notation to give both the domain and range of f in the inverse of f function. When it's referring to the f, it means our function f of x. We are given the function f of x is equal to 2x minus 3. Now, if you can recall, f of x is the same thing as writing y is equal to. So to find our inverse, I'm going to go ahead and rewrite our given function as y is equal to 2x minus 3. To find our inverse function, otherwise known as f negative 1, you have to swap your x and y variables. So they trade places. So when they trade places, we're going to have x is equal to 2y minus 3. Now we're going to go ahead and isolate our y variable just as we would if we were trying to get this in slope-intercept form again. So to do that, I'm going to add 3 to both sides. That'll get you 2y is equal to x plus 3. You want to isolate this y variable, so that means you have to divide the coefficient out. So you're going to divide each term by 2. So that will cancel out, and it'll leave you with y is equal to x divided by 2 plus 3 halves. And just for reference for when we're graphing, 3 halves is the same thing as 1.5. Now remember, with your slope, it's going to be rise over run, and our slope is 1/2, so it's going to rise 1 and run 2. And since it's a positive slope, it's going to be moving up towards quadrant 1. So now that we have our inverse, let's go ahead and write out our function so we can graph them. So we have our given f of x is equal to 2x minus 3, and our inverse function, x half plus 3 halves. Or you can write this as 1.5, whichever makes you understand it better. So I'm going to start by graphing our first function. So looking at our y-intercept, which is our negative 3, because y equals mx plus b, this is our y-inter, and the m is our slope. So going off of that, we're going to start our first one, f of x, at the y-intercept negative 3. So let's go down and plot a point. And our slope is 2x. So 2 over 1, meaning we're going to rise 2 since that's positive, 1, 2, and go over 1. I'm just going to complete this a few more units, just so we have a more complete line. And again, I'm going to go down 2 units and over 1. And recall that the direction says f as a solid line. Pay careful attention to these, just so when you're graphing it, you don't get the lines confused. So let's go ahead and draw the best solid line to my ability. That's not too bad. And now let's get to work on our inverse function. So when we're graphing our inverse, I'm going to do the same steps. I'm going to start with our y-intercept. That's going to be positive 1.5, so let's go here. 1.5. Let's start doing our slope. Our slope is, again, 1 over 2, rise 1 over 2. So be careful with this. Know that you have a 1.5, not a whole number such as 1 or 2. So pay careful attention to that 0.5 at the end. So we're going to go up 1 unit, and this is going to bring us half to 1 full unit to 2.5. We're going to go over 2. So from there, go 1, 2. And again, I'm going to just plot a few more points just so I can get a better line. So we're going to go up 1 over 2. I'm going to go down, down 1 over 2, down another unit over 2 units, so even more complete line. And again, for our inverse, we're doing a dashed line. So again, let's try to draw that out. It's not too bad. Now we have them both graphed. Now that we have them graphed, let's go ahead and do our domain. So for our function 1, I'm going to label that. Our domain in interval notation, so remember that interval notation is your parentheses or your brackets. We're going to be using parentheses in our case because we're not having any greater than or equal to or any of that good stuff, so it's just going to be our domain. So judging on our domain on our first function, you can see that there's no restrictions on it. It's continuously running on the x-axis from negative infinity to positive infinity, reading left to right. So we're going to start with parentheses, negative infinity to positive infinity. And for our range, again, reading the y-axis, as that's your y-values, reading from bottom to top. It doesn't have any restrictions, so it's going to be from negative infinity to positive infinity again. Follow the same steps for our inverse function. Looking at it, on our x-axis, you can see again there's no restrictions, none of that, so our domain is going to run continuously, reading from left to right, from negative infinity to positive infinity. So we're going to write that out like that. And as well as our range, reading from bottom to top, you can see it goes from a negative infinity to positive infinity continuously for our y values, otherwise known as our range. So everything is graphed correctly. Our domain and range are given. Good job. As always, comment below if you have any questions, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more math videos.